We have newly released body camera footage that sparked criminal charges against a Vermont State Police sergeant and trooper.
And an ongoing debate going on between law enforcement and the Attorney General's office ever since the charges were filed last month against the two troopers involved. NBC5's Liz Strepa joins us now from the newsroom with what both sides are saying tonight. Liz?
Brian and Alice, the Vermont Troopers Association and the Attorney General's office continue to disagree about whether or not the officer's use of force was justified in this case. Tonight, body camera footage is painting a clearer picture of what happened, and a warning, some viewers may find parts of this video disturbing.
Newly released body camera footage shows us exactly what happened on June 17th, 2022 at 2:38 a.m. in Newfane, Vermont.
Put it on the ground now!
You can see Vermont State Police Sergeant Ryan Wood and Trooper Zachary Trockey are trying to negotiate with the victim, who was allegedly standing on a roof holding a saw. This is Trooper Trockey's body camera footage, where you can see he's loading a beanbag round. The victim is warned multiple times to drop the saw.
Drop the saw! Drop the saw!
I will! Come on!
Drop it now!
When he doesn't comply, another warning.
Beanbag, beanbag, beanbag!
Beanbag!
A non-lethal beanbag round is fired. The victim falls to the ground. He survived that fall. The situation leading to intense back and forth between the Vermont Troopers Association and Attorney General Charity Clark after Clark's office decided to charge Trooper Trockey and Sergeant Wood with reckless endangerment for their use of force. The two officers pleading not guilty to their charges in court last month. Clark's office receiving backlash from some community members. NBC5 News received a copy of the letter that her office sent to her constituents. In it, she defends her right to charge the trooper, saying in part, "Police use of force is only justified when it is objectively reasonable and necessary to defend against an imminent threat of death or serious bodily injury to the officer or to another person. The decision to bring criminal charges against any officer in the line of duty is only made after a careful and detailed review of the totality of the circumstances. Thankfully, officer actions in our state rarely require a criminal response, but in the instances they do, I am committed to the judicial process and ensuring that all evidence is heard in a fair trial." The Vermont Troopers Association responding this week, saying Trooper Trockey's and Sergeant Wood's use of force was justified. The association says Clark is confusing lethal force with non-lethal force. Their statement goes on to say, "Anyone who has watched the recently released video of the incident is well aware Sergeant Wood and Trooper Trockey did not apply lethal force, nor did they intend to do so. In fact, they applied a less lethal weapon in an attempt to gain compliance of a person armed with a potentially deadly weapon who was not following their instructions, and they did so in order to avoid the possibility of needing to use lethal force." NBC5 News reached back out to Clark's office for a response, which reads, "The court found probable cause for the charge of reckless endangerment in this case. We look forward to putting the evidence before the community."
Put it on the ground now!
As the community is now able to take a closer look at what happened.
Now, if both officers are convicted, the misdemeanor charge is punishable by 1 year in prison or a $1,000 fine. Liz Strepa, NBC5 News.
Liz, thank you. Police are investigating after a...